notes for my application in the grid pane, also in the border pane. First, I'll start with the grid pane. This is the class for the grid pane, the layout where I have my grid pane, and this is the main method. This is the class where the cars are registered. I'll run the app. Please bear with me, my computer is really slow. These are the cars that I have in already. You can see. And this is the add button. Link, but if I have a picture link to show down there, just GPG. You can see there the color has been added. There's no picture, that's why. And I can delete the car, and now it tells me it's just four cars in the method. And if I want to search for a car, let's see, I want to search for. Search for this registration number. I can search the registration number. You can see the app works now to show you the method and the classes. Like I said, this is the inbuilt cars I already have. So this is the text field. And this is the inbuilt cars and the pictures. And this is the method for adding. Set the registration number and the pictures, and this is the method for deleting, where it says if the car I'm calling up, if it requires the registration number, delete the cars in the setting array, which is E, and this is the method for updating, and this is the method for searching. And this is the method for spinning up every, like the whole cars. The method for this is the output method that shows on the prompter, like shows the cars. So every time I add a car, it tells me how many cars I have in the array and what's the cars numbers. And this is the method for going back and front. This is how we set the buttons. And this is how we set the gap and the horizontal gap and the vertical gap and the padding and the position where I want it to be. That is for the grid pane. Now let's go to the border pane. This is the border pane. In the border pane, edit it.